You've got it. You act a card. To honor your father's dying wish and take up his crown.
Suppose I don't want his crown.
You forsake his kingdom. All of his treasures.
Treasures? You mean like this? We drink straight out of the bottle, don't we, boys?
Yeah!
Or this? Nothing about the sun and moon to light our way.
Yeah!
Or this? No thanks. I'd rather eat with my bare hands.
Yeah!
Your prince style, not a common sailor.
These men are anything but common. They're free, Grimsby. Truly free. They don't have to answer to anyone but the sea. I'd rather be a sailor than a prince any day. This is where I belong. Everything seems more real here. Strange how at home I feel here in the tide's swift flow. And with a calm strong, I almost think I hear the sea wild and free, calling me from fathoms below. There it is again.
Snarf blacks.
Ooh.
Second cousin to the
Picnics? Music?
Sure thing, kid! I just don't smoke. My makes music so fantabulous. So absolutely.
Music? Oh no, the concert! I completely forgot! My father's gonna kill me!
The concert was today?
Oh my father, thank you so much!
You changed your mind, Louisa! Come in first, you hear?
Benevolent merfolk, creatures of the deep. Today marks a special anniversary. For on this day, many years ago, I inherited my father's kingdom and banished the sea witch Ursula forever.
Hail, King Triton!
Hail, King Triton!
And now it's time for us to celebrate our victory. May I introduce the master of ceremonies.
Presenting the court composer.
Horatio, Polonius, Ignatius, Crustaceous, Sebastian!
Morning to y'all!
So, what have you in store?
I got a special song just for the occasion, and it's gonna be performed by none other than your seven lovely daughters! I wrote this song for my star pupil.
And who might that be?
Your youngest, Ariel. Such a voice, that child. Notes as clear as ice, pitch as pure as water. Why, I haven't heard such a voice since your majesty.
Since her royal highness. May she rest in peace.
You're gonna be a proud papa. You'll see. If only she'd come to rehearsals once in a while.
Let the merriment begin.
Oh, we are the daughters of Triton, great father who loves us and made us well, of water and tree, the Prista, Tila, Della, Mama, and Ariel.
Oh,
given such a gift.
I know my mother's voice.
It's a wondrous talent, one that demands stewardship and care. So please, for the sake of remembering.
I will, Daddy, I can promise.
It wasn't even Ariel's fault! That mother of Siegel just kept going on and on.
Siegel!
And on.
Siegel! You went up to the surface again!
Nothing happened!
You could have been seen by one of those barbarians, one of those humans!
Daddy, they're not barbarians!
They're dangerous, traps and harpoons! Like it or not, Ariel, you're my youngest, my baby, and I worry about you the most.
But I'm old enough to take care of myself!
As long as you live under my roof, you'll obey my rules!
If you would just listen to me,
that's the last time you're ever swimming up to the surface! Understood?
You're so unfair!
Heaven help me. She's headstrong, willful, stubborn as mud.
Teenagers, you give them an inch and they swim all over you.
I can govern a kingdom, but I can't control my own daughter. I was too harsh. She'll learn to fear me. I don't want that. She needs her mother, Sebastian, and so do I.
If only she were here, she'd know just what to say. She'd firmly and yet gently help the girl to find her way. She'd know what to forbid and what we must allow. She'd have the strength and patience that I lack somehow. I would give to have her back. Right
down now, Saga. It's difficult, sure, but you've got to toughen up, not melt down. For Ariel's sake, that child needs concept of a vision, someone who can watch over her, keep her out of trouble.
That's not a bad idea. Someone to safeguard her every move,
her every dog hurdle,
her every side stroke,
every dive.
And you are just the grab to do it.
What?
You heard me. From now on, Ariel is your responsibility.
But Saya, she's a clever mermaid. I just took a station. Surely you should pick someone higher on the evolutionary scale.
Yeah. When I meet the girl of my dreams, it'll hit me like lightning.
that is a terrible tumble, dear one.
No, I'll prove it to you. I'll find her and I'll thank her for saving my life.
You best come with me. My night is sleeping, you'll be good as new.
No, please, you have to believe me.
There are too many tall tales, my boy.
No, she was real.
Yes, of course she was. As real as a siren, as real as a mermaid on the rocks.
I'm sorry.
present deal. Where has she swum off to now? I got to find her before my daddy goes looking.
Good luck. She's in La La Land.
That girl is head over tails in love.
Ariel, in love?
Come on, Flounder. Who's the lucky mermaid?
Gee, I don't know. I didn't even know it was love until the second chorus.
Right.
Out a melody too lovely to withstand.
Oh, child.
I thought maybe, just maybe, you'd be happy for me.
Happy for you? Because you're going to come crazy now? Child, you've got to get your head out of the clouds and back into the water where it belongs.
But I don't belong here. I don't fit in as hard as I try. Only I could be up there where he is instead. Looking on the very same ground, breathing the very same air.
Down here is your home. The human world. It's a mess. Life under the sea is better than anything they got up there.
No, Mom, I swear.
Believe me, child. It's true. Ariel.
It's a mockery of everything we hold dear. Where is she?
If only I knew, but I...
She keeps secrets from me, but not from you. I'll reckon you know where she is. Take me to her.
Please, I have to go!
So pass the charm,
tiny spell,
and learn more, tell
me!
go.
Nonsense! With them.
Father says your magic is wicked and evil.
Yes, but he says the same thing of humans, doesn't he, Snuckums? And we both know that's not true.
Don't.
Why did he vanish you?
The ocean wasn't big enough for the both of us. And now he's driven you away, too.
He doesn't understand me.
Oh, but I do, don't we? We're so very alike, you and I. Down with that vision!
Nothing scares a man more, does it? Now, tell General Auntie everything.
I'm in love with someone. A human?
Yes, this prince fellow, he's my guest. The answer is simple. You've got to become a human yourself.
Can you help me?
Help
me. My dear sweet child, it's what I live for.
To help!
Unfortunately, there don't like yourself.
So, with no one else concerned,
I admit that in the past I've been nasty. They were kidding when they called me the witch. But you'll find it now, Lee. I've made it all my way. Like to see a switch to me. And I fortunately know a little magic. It's a talent that I always have possessed. And dear lady, please don't laugh. I know you're going to be half of the miserable, the lonely, and depressed. Someone couldn't pay the price, and I'm afraid I had to bring the cross to gold. You got time, you know, wait, but on a whole I've never sent to those far unfortunate souls. Here's my best novel, hey, I know a spell that will turn you into a human for 3 days. Now, it's got your procedural clothes, sort of a squid pro quo. Before the sun sets on the third day, you've got to get dear old Princey to kiss you. If you do, you'll stay human forever.
And if I don't?
Oh, nothing tragic, darling, I'm sure. Oh, look, small prince! Your soul is mine forever, and you need this many eternity in my watery house of glare. Lawyer, don't you just love him?
Of course, there is one more thing.
My fee.
But I don't have anything.
I'm not asking for much.
Only
my voice!
Don't worry, I have this perfect place for it. Your grandfather decided to give this trident to your father, but this was his gift for.
Your magic shell?
You've heard about it?
Father says it's the source of all your magic.
Nonsense, darling.
He says you die without me.
Die? Please, it's a bottle, a vessel for your blood. Trust me, darling. Your barata, your legato, even your belt.
They'll all be safe and sound in here.
But family again. Not my sisters, not even my father.
Do you want Principal or not? I want Principal!
Yes! Yes! Where do I sign?
Not just any dog. Use love.
Fall in love with her. Yeah, and to prove it, he gets to
But if she never comes back, and I'm forced to sing her song, Good evening. How are you? Speechless. Hungry?
Thank you.
Fish out of water. I'm sorry, did I say something wrong? Well, who needs words anyway? A smile can say just as much sometimes. Sure. Dancing is the way your feet smile or laugh. It can say so many things.
Dance is like
I haven't been myself lately. I shall let you get some rest. It's almost midnight. Good night.
Out of the frying pan and into the fire, the things I do for you, child. Now I know what I ought to do. I ought to tell your poor father about this, and you can be miserable for the rest of your life. It's true. I got no backbone. All right, child, I'm in. But we've got to come up with a plan to get that money to kiss you. Well, you've got to put up to your eyes like this. And you've got to put up your lips like this. You put those two things together and you'll have that boy in the palm of your hand. Yes, just like that, just like that. Now, I have to let you go, I have to let you go.
Alexandra.
Yes, sir.
Annabelle.
Yes, sir.
Beatrice.
Must have been some kind of freak storm. We gotta get back. Tomorrow's my birthday, and we're holding a contest. Griffin wants to be married by sunset or else.
I'd simply obey the law and
here.
Her father was all of Prussia. She's richer than Midas. She's one of triplets, but they're going to break up the set.
No!
What am I to do? You'd be the death of me, boy. Why, the sun is nearly set. Your birthday's almost over.
Ariel?
For heaven's sake, child, you mustn't.
Quiet, Grimsby. Go ahead, Ariel.
It's my power.
Which would you rather be? The king of the sea
proud of you. Your mother would be too. It seems in the blink of an eye, when my back was turned, you grew up. You love him very much, don't you?
It's what she truly wants, Your Majesty. More than anything. Please.
Daughter.
Does that upset you?
I haven't, no. I'm just...